Alright, I am done. Your smarter, cooler, faster, intelligenter, beautifuler sister is done with finding out how many gallons of fuel will go into our rocket.
Yeah, your sister that makes up words that don't even exist is done.
So where will the first stop be anyways once this rocket is fueled?
Well, our first stop will be Mars. Hold on, quiet. Looks like we're getting a transmission that is coming in from the space station.
Come in. Team Genesis, come in.
Yes, this is Team Genesis. We are here. What is going on?
We're gonna need some backup. The space station has come under attack.
Attacked? By who? Who would dare do such a thing?
I don't know by whom, but the invaders left some clues. They left a trail of sticky, slimy, gooey blob all over the space station. And whatever this gooey stuff is, it really stinks.
A gooey what? Where at? And what does it smell like?
You can find most of the gooey, stinky blob in the command center of the space station where we have our main computer. The blob is real thick. It's colored bright green. It kind of looks like jello. But when you touch it, it's as if it comes alive and starts to dance. It wiggles everywhere. It smells really strong. Kind of like old rotten cheese. The smell is so strong it makes my nose burn. You all better speed up the launch so you can help us investigate.
Copy that. I will keep you posted.
Alright, we'll be waiting for you. Gotta go. I need to at least try to clean this mess up.
Alright, see you soon.
I know this is gonna sound really weird, but hearing about the blob that was gooey and slimy made me kind of hungry. I'm craving some jello. And pizza. Pizza with stinky Parmesan cheese.
What? Hungry? Ew!
Yes, I know. My stomach's growling.
Okay, well, when you are done, I will order you a pizza. But as of now, we need to hurry up and finish loading our spaceship with everything we need for our exploration. And in order for you to do this, you need to know how to compare and order numbers.
Okay, I'm ready.
The last time we were in the thinking tank, we went over the place value chart. Today, we will be going over how to compare and order numbers. There are three symbols we use when comparing numbers. One is greater than, the other one is less than, and the third one is equal to. For example, 80 is greater than 50, or the number 24 is less than 90. Now, if we were to compare 15 with the number 15, both of these numbers are equal to each other.
This is easy to understand.
When we compare numbers that have multiple digits, for example, 3,569 to 2,987, we need to look at the digit that has the greatest place value in each number. To help us with this, let's put both numbers in a place value chart. Now that we have organized both numbers in a place value chart, which digit in 3,569 has the greatest value?
Well, that's super easy.
The 3, because it's in the thousands place. The 3 has a value of 3,000. Awesome. And how about the number 2,987? Which digit in 2,987 has the greatest value?
That's easy too. The digit 2 has the greatest value because it's also in the thousands place. And it has a value of 2,000.
So I have a question for you. What number do you think is greater, 3,569 or 2,987?
Well, since I know that 3,000 is greater than 2,000, the number 3,569 has to be the bigger number.
So now use one of our symbols to show which number is greater.
Got it. I would write this as 3,569 is greater than 2,987.
Phenomenal! The last thing I want to show you is that we can rewrite a number in expanded form. This also can help us compare numbers digit by digit. Are you ready?
I was born ready. Bring it on.
Okay, here we go. Let's compare the number 23,587 with 23,489. We're going to begin by representing each number in expanded form. If we were to identify the value of each digit within 23,587, I know that 2 has a value of 20,000 because it is in the 10,000s place. 3 has a value of 3,000 because it is in the 1,000s place. The number 5 has a value of 500 because it is in the 100s place. 8 has a value of 80 because it is in the 10s place. And 7 has a value of 7 because it is in the 1s place. If I take each of the values within this number, I can represent it in an expanded form as 20,000 plus 3,000 plus 500 plus 80 plus 7. Does this make sense?
Yes. Easy peasy.
Okay, go ahead and represent 23,489 in expanded form.
Sure. In expanded form, this number would be 20,000 plus 3,000 plus 400 plus 80 plus 9.
That was perfect! Now the last step is going to be for us to compare the value of each digit in both numbers to identify the larger number. So we can see that 20,000 is the same as 20,000, so let's cross these two numbers out and move on to the next place value. 3,000 is the same as 3,000, so we can cross these out as well. So what do you notice about 500 and 400?
That 500 is greater than 400.
Awesome! So it looks like we found our greater number. Since 500 is greater than 400, we know that 23,587 has to be greater than 23,489.
This was a piece of cake.
Cake.
Yum.
You did great, and always remember the symbols for greater than, less than, and equal to. The equal is easy because it's an equal sign. For the other two, you just need to think about it as a hungry alligator.
Like me. I'm starving.
Exactly. If you're starving, you will want to eat the most food. So the open alligator mouth will always be open to eat the greater of number, and the small point will point toward the smaller number.
So much learning makes me so hungry.
I bet I could eat a roasted alligator.
Ugh. You're so random. Well, I have to admit, I am glad you are learning. Now let me go order that pizza for you before you start eating everything in sight.
Yes, please.
Now figure out what is the best mountain we should launch from to save some fuel. Mount Everest has a height of 29,032 feet. K2 has a height of 28,251 feet. Or Broad Peak, that has a height of 26,414 feet.
This should be easy. Just give me a couple of minutes.
Awesome. Remember, we are trying to launch from the mountain that has the greatest height.